And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Rakdos Control. We got Puppy in here. She's gonna join us here for this match or league or so, or just for a little bit at least. She's gonna join us. This is my dog. Her name's Puppy. Anyway, this is Rakdos Control. I've played a couple of different Rakdos decks recently. Like, we played Rakdos Aggro with Experimental Frenzy. And the Experimental Frenzies were just, like, our best card in our deck by a long ways. And then, of course, the Rakdos Spirit deck, which is a lot of fun with Pestilent Spirit. The Theater of Horrors is really what that deck's built around. That card was incredible. So I've been thinking, like, what if we just kind of combine those together and worry about Theater of Horrors and Experimental Frenzy getting us a ton of card advantage? And, you know, just play, like, Rakdos Removal with lots of card advantage and just outgrind the opponents. I think that's a pretty good game plan, and so that's what we got going on here with this deck. So yeah, like our main cards, we got the three Theater of Horrors and the three Experimental Frenzies that we're going to be trying to use for lots of card advantage. Chandra Fire Artisan also getting us some extra cards, and also can do like the ultimate for some more damage to help us finish games out. But then our deck is just a whole bunch of removal. You know, we got a couple of duresses, but then, you know, Shock, Carnival, where if our opponent's not really playing low loyalty planeswalkers or creatures, we can use the Carnage part also. You know, Legion's End, Noxious Grass, Rampage, Bone Crusher Giant, Murder Threat, like, this is just all removal. So we get it's pretty nice being able to put a deck together with just two huge card advantage engines and then just tons of removal. Murderous Rider and Bone Crusher Giant are just perfect because they're removal spells that are also creatures that can help us finish games. So yeah, we'll be attacking with Bone Crusher Giants and Murderous Riders to finish out games here. But then we can also just do 20 with Theater Force. You know, like this is going to be a damage source. 4 damage, do 1 damage to them. Or 4 mana, deal 1 damage to them. That's kind of the plan. I could see that being very slow. Definitely could see that being very slow. In the sideboard, to speed that up, if we're worrying about milling out, I got 3 Ashioks that can be a little bit faster, eat at our opponent's library. Also very good against the Dance of the Man decks. Cry the Carnarium for Edgewall Innkeeper and Cauldron Familiar. Davriel against Control. If we want to go attack the hand more, we got Duress, Davriel, and then some other good removal spells with Legion's End, Noxious Grasp, couple Elder spells if they're going with a ton of Planeswalkers. We already have a good amount of Planeswalker removal with 3 Rider, 3 Bedevil, 4 Rampage, and even Noxious Grass for like Okos and stuff. So we got a good amount of Planeswalker removal here also. Okay, so let's give this a try. We're going to play over in Ranked. That's the R means. We're going to try this deck over there in Ranked. We're going to play four or five matches or so. No, there's not auto losses. That's not a thing. What's the win condition here? I literally just went through and explained that, but yeah, we're going to be using Theater of Horrors as our main win condition, but we have the creatures are going to be attacking. All right, let's go ahead and keep this. We have creatures, we attack them. I don't understand the question. Like, why, you know, how do we bring our enemy to zero? We attack. Okay, Temple, Overgrown Tomb. I'm gonna ditch. It's either Noxious Grasp or Angrath's Rampage here. I don't want my opponent to play another Urok's Fenlurker. That could be devastating. All right, Abzan. Midnight Reaper is, of course, a good one against my deck, but that's alright. You know, they basically have, it's like the same thing as them having ETB draw a card. Yeah, this is Puppy. One thing I found out today is that... All right, so I'm saving the rampage for the Citadel. One thing I found out today is Puppy really loves my swing. I have a swing in the yard, just on like a little hill. And going down, because the hill goes down, and it's like the swing goes out, so it makes it seem like you're swinging over. And I basically like never used the swing, even though I've lived here for like 2 years. But I was just out with the dogs today and decided to get on the swing. Just kind of felt like it, and Puppy jumped up on my lap, and we swang, and she had such a fun time. So that was really cool. All right, so they don't have... So that was a lot of fun seeing how excited she was about being on the swing. Didn't have the third black for Citadel with the double planes. Yeah, that's her name, Puppy. Wait, so they did have the black mana there, but then didn't play Citadel? Because they wanted to be able to play Citadel and still get the extra land drop. Makes sense. Angel of Grace. Should have named the dog Eyehawk. That's really bad for me. That's also very bad. I really would have liked to have this other rampage be able to take out the Angel of Grace. That's not how life's gonna be. And now they have this 1/1 now. Cavalier of Knights, obviously a huge problem. Also, oh, this is gonna be tough. I don't have a plan really here. Got to stabilize the battlefield first before these things can take over. It's kind of the problem of drawing three of the... That's why I'm only playing three theaters and three frenzies, because if you just draw three of them like we did there, but you haven't stabilized the battlefield, it doesn't help out. All right, so Midnight Reaper is rough. Cavalier of Night in particular, that's really rough. Cavalier of Night getting back Midnight Reaper. Don't you miss Vraska's Contempt, puppy? Don't you miss Vraska's Contempt? So we don't really see anything for Legion's End besides the Urok's Fenlurker. If I just don't play Legion's End and I play Cry of the Carnarium, which is awesome against Reaper, and can just clean up some other stuff. And then just play Grasp instead of Soot for Angel of Grace and Lovestruck Beast. Let's kind of go Cry, Grasp. Could definitely see them playing a lot more spells here after sideboarding. You know, we just don't really know what's going on with their deck. I could see them playing a lot more spells. They had the other knight too. This kind of deck is definitely good to hit the land drops, because if we can get the extra cards with like Frenzy and stuff, we want to be able to hit our land drops. More foxes? Yeah, that's true. That fox isn't working too well. We got the blue, the black. We'll go Black Fox here. Charming Prince. That makes sense. Maybe I should have boarded out some Rampages. Play a couple Duress instead of a couple of Rampage. Yep, I have a dog. I have two dogs. This is Puppy. The other dog's Harvey. Harvey's a lot bigger. It's harder to bring Harvey here in the room. They don't usually... let's see. They're not usually allowed in my room because this is Hawkeye's room. And Puppy's all camera shy. So no land drop there, even with the double scry. So they scryed four and didn't hit any land drop. That's pretty unlucky. All right, maybe replace two with two Legion's Ends. They got extra two drops there that we don't. We'll one Legion's End, get a third Duress, two Rampage. All right, here we go. More Puppy. The risk with this hand is not hitting the land drops. If we don't hit land drops, this is going to be rough. No, Harvey's never been on stream. I posted pictures of Harvey in the Discord channel, under the pet section of the Discord channel. But no, Harvey's never been in here on stream. So Murderous Rider is a terrible draw step. I need to draw land. It's the the risk with this hand. If I was on the play, I would not have kept this hand, but on the draw with getting that extra card. Jeez, just drew double three drop with our two mana. Come on, deck. Be nice. Well, it's better than not drawing a land, even though it doesn't help me right away. Yeah, Fable of Passage can be rough at times.
I will have revenge for House Markov.
That thing bringing back Midnight Reaper is so good. Alright, I hate this hand. We can only single spell every turn. This is really, really rough.
A reckoning will come one day.
So the Sorin trades with my Murderous Rider, but then also has a Midnight Reaper in play that's going to trade with something else and draw them a card. That was a great Sorin. Well, hopefully I draw Cry of the Cranarium. I guess I probably just can't just take a bunch of damage. Yeah, Abbot of Carol Keep was a fun card to play. That was a good design. I mean, if we're gonna draw a three drop, at least hopefully we draw Cry of the Cranarium, like our only, like our most important three drop. If you would have told me I was going to draw one land in, you know, seven draws, I would have definitely mulliganed. I don't think it's been six draws. I would have definitely mulliganed in a heartbeat. Yeah, I have 24 in the deck for lands. We want to hit our first, you know, like, four land drops. But then, you know, like, Frenzy and...
Your corpse will make an excellent minion from battle to grave.
I should have sacked the two creatures. But Frenzy and Theater help us hit the land drops in the late game and everything, but... They should have kept the token and sacked the Fenlurker. They could have drawn another card. Hey, Pitch. I should have just mulliganed my hand. Two land wasn't enough. Opponent still has 8 cards over there, plus the Lovestruck Beast, so they still have 9 cards. Cool. Alright, moving on. I think what I've learned today... The one thing that I've learned today is that Midnight Reaper is absolutely amazing. We've tried 2 control decks so far. And we've had 3 Midnight Reaper decks that have just destroyed us. That card has just consistently been destroying me. It's just been, you know, Midnight Reapers followed by Midnight Reapers. What a good card. That's a card people don't really talk about at all. It's a really good one. Gets overlooked. So I should probably wait to Ritual of Soot before playing Bone Crusher Giant. I am not going to make them sacrifice that. Oh, I just didn't play my Fable Passage. Alright, well that one's my bad. I was going to be saying that I don't know what color... Hey, it's my deck. I don't know what color to grab yet, whether it's red or black, so I wasn't really going to be... I wasn't going to activate this. I was just... That's what I was going to be talking about, but I just didn't. All right, well, we figured it out. And... Looks like I'm not casting Ritual Upset, so. Hey, we have another raid. Caden's Gaming Lounge. With the raid. Welcome, everybody. From Caden's Gaming Lounge, we are currently playing some Rakdos Control over here with help of my dog, Puppy. And
I only pick targets. Oh, I was getting bored.
Haven't been
anyway.
Doing too good today, win-loss wise, but not gonna do great every day.
I've suffered worse.
Yeah, I don't have Puppy on very often. This is Hawkeye's room. I don't usually, like, the dogs don't usually come in here at all. Wait, is it... I'm planning on doing the Omniscience draft later on tonight. That card. Is it gone or something now? I didn't know it was ending so soon. Oh, it went down about an hour ago because it was super bugged. Oh, okay. Yeah, hopefully it comes back. Because, yeah, that is a fun event. That was, like, my plan for fourth today. I don't know how I'm going to beat this Midnight Reaper. Got to kill that thing, of course. But I don't know what I'm going to do here now. So unclear if my opponent is going 4 color, or if they are just if they're just going Jund and having like Midnight Reaper replace Oko. Yeah, wrong Chandra. This Chandra doesn't have a minus. Yeah, that, you're thinking of the 6-mana Chandra. Yeah, 6-mana Chandra could minus in exile. So drawing a black source would be really nice here, where I could Ritual of Soot and then Rampage. No, the Cauldron Familiar still comes back. I've also learned that I need a lot more than two Cry of the Carnariums. And Cry of the Carnarium, I guess, is amazing if all we're going to do is play against Midnight Reaper decks. I don't know. Haven't had any luck here, though. Yeah, we just played it. We played that food deck yesterday, and also had really bad draws. Yeah, they had two foods, though. Ashiok can exile Cauldron Familiar while it's in the graveyard, but usually they can just bring Cauldron Familiar back into play. So it's not a very good answer. I'm going to play extra Duresses. Maybe you can take like Witch's Oven, Vraska. Well, Wicked Wolf doesn't die to Ritual of Soot. Wicked Wolf costs 4 mana. It's the problem is the sleeves. I just do arena. Yeah, puppy's pretty camera shy. So we haven't been able to enact our game plan at all of like kind of stabilize and play like Theater Fours or Frenzy or Chandra on you like a stable battlefield. It just never happened. Oh no. Exactly what's wrong. Really hope they don't just have Golgari Queen again. Whatever. It's not as bad, I guess. I don't know, it's about the same. You have zero Brazen Borrowers, what would you recommend to replace them with an Azorius Circle? Probably some... I don't know, I'd have to, I mean, you want to replace it with removal. I'd have to kind of really look at the list to see exactly what, but you want to replace it with removal. You know, like maybe like Prison Realm or Glass Casket, or, you know, maybe you play Time Wipes or something. Just, you need removal there. I guess, could potentially replace with Counter Magic too, I suppose. That could also work. Definitely interaction, though. This would be a perfect turn to play one of our eight top end, you know, card advantage cards. This is like, this game's actually working out well. Like, this is what we're trying to do. This would be a perfect turn here. To have a Theater of Horrors or a Chandra or something like that. Even a Frenzy, even with having like the two cards in hand, like it's still just a good time for a Frenzy too. You don't have to always have zero cards in hand whenever you play Experimental Frenzy. Sometimes it's worth it just to play it to start hitting more land drops and digging. Yep, gotta accrue that value. So it looks like my opponent's just going Jund and having Midnight Reaper replace Oko, which honestly maybe that would be better. I didn't have too much success with Oko yesterday. Midnight Reaper is awesome, as we've seen here today. My two red black based control decks have been especially struggling with Midnight Reaper. I don't know what's going on over there. I'm just gonna start attacking. Hey, Nug. Welcome. Opponent, don't disconnect and be gone. You're doing good. You're up a game. You got four cards in hand. You're doing good. Puppy looks about done. I'm not going to really count that as a victory. My opponent's pizza just got delivered. Pizza sounds good. Yeah, Grixis Amass. I mean, I wish we could have played the deck. We didn't really play any Magic. It was really sad. We just had lots and lots of lands every game and stuff like that. This has just kind of been my day. We're just mulling to five and can't play anything. So I can't beat, like, any of these cards. Basically can't beat any of these cards. I'll go the super greedy line of take discovery. Hope they don't draw a land. Oh wait, they can still play Saheeli. Oh well. Never mind, I'm dead. The most competitive non-Oko deck is probably Azorius Control. Alright, got rid of two of those. All right, puppy, you want to go back? All right.
True goodness can never be corrupted.
Here you go. I'm going to put Tick puppy back to the living room. Stone Coil Serpent.
I am proud.
So I have Legion's End for Stone Coil Serpent. They just don't even play it? They just play nothing? Right, I'm hoping to hit a land drop here.
You and I are gonna take them out. Sit back and watch it burn.
Cool. Because, you know, any other card we weren't going to be able to cast. So they're good against... Mystic Forge is protected against... It's definitely protected against Antgrass Rampage. Alright, thin the deck.
Past is unwritten.
It's worth it to play the land there, because we could have it. We could have, speaking of Rampage, we could have Rampage on top. Alright, we'll have an upkeep stop to be able to bedevil the Ugin on upkeep. I kind of need bedevil the Mystic Forge, though, also. Like, bedevil's my only answer for Mystic Forge, where I have other Planeswalker removal.
Secrets manifest before you.
No, Grixis of Mass was cool. We just played a lot of games like where our mana was terrible. I haven't been lucky today at all. It's just been a really poor day of Magic. It's not really our deck's fault, it's just variance. I mean, this deck may need to be able to put more pressure on the opponent, admittedly. This is tough between Mystic Forge and Ugin. Can I see this first before I target? Yay. Oh wait, no, I have to draw this card. No. No.
Caution, mortals.
I guess I should have tapped this because of shock. That could have been shock there, and then I would have been able to shock the Ugin. I really have both of these control decks really designed, like, with all of, like, my answers and everything. I really have them designed with, like, the, you know, trying to beat the food decks. And instead, all we're playing against are our Midnight Reaper and Cauldron Familiar decks. So I can't really Engrass Rampage away the Midnight Clocks.
Today I craft my victory.
We've played basically. I have four Engrass Rampage in both of these decks. I'm talking about like how good Engrass Rampage is right now. And how I really like it right now. And we have played against zero decks where Engrass Rampage is any good. So that has not been good. Anyway, what's up, John? It's almost midnight there. I'm trying to keep these clocks from striking midnight. Yeah, some days you get paired up against exactly what you want to play against. Some days you don't.
I will not stop.
Murderous Rider? All right. Not Frenzy. All right. Hey, QQ. Oh, good, Mercury Shot. You had a good run with Grixis and Mass today. Good job. Happy to hear that. We'll be changing up our deck quite a bit after sideboard in here. Well, I don't know about quite a bit, but some. These things really do reduce the effectiveness of Rampage. It'd be nice to be able to take out these other artifacts with Rampage. Oh, I missed the Mobilized District. All right, so that's lethal. Whatever I block with Murderous Rider, they sacrifice to Oven. I don't gain life. Get rid of these. Get these. And we're going to try the Ashiok approach. I mean, do I just board out? So the problem here is, I can go. The problem here is too many cards that cost too much mana, which is kind of the problem of taking out Angrass Rampages. I don't want to have this many three drops, basically. That's what I'm getting at there. I feel like I need to keep the Rampages. I think Shock and Legion's Ends are my worst cards, but again, I can't just have a deck full of threes. I guess I don't really have a choice, though. I mean, I could have Kryler Carnarium to stop the Cauldron Familiar thing. I'm going to try, like, Ashiok, I guess. Yeah, Cry is good against the cat. I'm not that worried about the cat. I'm worried about the rest of the deck, honestly. All right, we'll play one Cry, because it's a Healy. My deck doesn't seem very aggressive. Yeah, we're a control deck. You can't do anything to stop Cry of the Carnarium from exiling your cat. Cry of the Carnarium exiles Cauldron Familiar. You can't do anything. It's not like a good player would stop that. Like, you can't. There's nothing to do to stop it. All right, so that first hand was just like how we had, that other game. Like, where, you know, I had two lands and then like four cards that cost three mana, and that's just going to be a hand that we're just going to get so bottlenecked on mana, just like we saw before. And so I went ahead and mulliganed that one, and now we got a lot more lands, so at least we won't be bottlenecked on mana now. And I can get two lands out of my deck also to make it so that we only have, you know, just to take two lands out and try to give us a better chance of drawing spells. I may just play this Experimental Frenzy this next turn. No, it's the first part. Exile all creature cards in all graveyards that were put there from the battlefield at this turn. So if you're a creature from the battlefield, you get exiled. Man, they have protection for Rampage? Ugh. Wow, that's perfect. That is just a perfect turn. Yeah, that was perfect. That was a bad Ashiok turn of just four lands. That was not good.
You strike out of fear.
Oh, well, they missed a land drop, so maybe it was good. Basically, that's all I'm doing is just attacking some of their library, making it more difficult on them.
Enjoy the illusion of victory.
that was a mistake playing the land from my hand. Could have just played this one from could have just played it from the theater for us. Kind of decided what I was doing there afterwards. What do you mean, Angrath and then exile it? No, if I there's no way for me to exile this with Ashiok with this here. There's no possible way to try to kill the Cauldron Familiar and then Ashiok, because they just bring it right back. Whatever removal I use, they sacrifice the Cauldron Familiar immediately, and then I activate Ashiok, and then they bring it back. And I can't go, like, sacrifice an artifact, because they have the Guild Globe. If they didn't have the Guild Globe, I could do something, but they do have the Guild Globe, unfortunately. Two removals? Well, they don't bring back the Cauldron Familiar until I activate, and then in response to activating, then they bring it back.
I leave.
There are greater battles to fight.
My victory was but a dream.
Like, what do you want me to, like, shock it with? All right, so I shock it first. They get rid of it, and then what? Then
welcome
I rampage. But then I would activate Ashiok.
Behold.
And then it comes back.
Remember.
And then if I rampage and sacrifice it afterwards, it doesn't just get exiled afterwards. Alright, so they're down to 27 cards. I'm keeping the Bonecrusher Giant back to be able to block 4 Ashiok here. Oh yeah, if I go, okay, I guess it would work. I was thinking of leading with Stomp, but yeah, if I lead with Rampage, because I activate Ashiok, they put the cat back in, and then I still respond before Ashiok and Stomp Cauldron Familiar. It is a lot of work to get through, but yeah, I guess that would work. All right, so I'm going to upkeep Bonecrusher Giant to do 2 damage to them, which will then also turn on Theater of Horrors and get me all these lands.
Evil must not be stand down.
I guess I'm gonna. Oh no! But now that doesn't turn on theater now.
We should discuss our differences.
Why am I targeting that thing? What am I doing? Target the Karn. That's not going to do 1 damage to them again now. Ugh. Alright, I'm not playing well. Thank you. I have two main deck Noxious Grasps. And they've been very bad.
Aww, say hello to my little friend.
To 11. Go down to 9. So they'd rather have the Guild Globe than the Karn? Surprising. Can you explain Omniscience Draft to me? Like I'm 5. Basically, every card, you don't have lands, and every card cost 0 mana. So there's no lands. You start each... Each person starts with 3 cards instead of 7, and you just have 0 mana. And have fun.
We are but motes in a vast multi-truth lies beyond.
So Bedevil is the card that I need to find. We're digging quickly. There we go. That's good. I guess I can't kill Ugin, though, also. Maybe I should leave that there for next turn. I think I have a plan. Nah, this is not really a very good plan. So, like, I need the Bedevil to kill the Spyglass. Right? I gotta kill Spyglass. What, there's 17 cards over there? The problem is I don't get to kill Ugin as well.
A foolish move.
This turn. Yeah, I could have attacked them and gotten Elder Spell. Did kind of want to just force them to attack, though. So, like... Yeah, I should have had the Murderous Rider attack them. I don't know. I have to make them block, though. Oh, they just let the cat go.
Do not pick.
They didn't bring the cat back.
I aspire for more.
All right, that does make my life easier. Maybe I should have pinged the Ugin so they couldn't just kill Ugin. Or they couldn't kill Ashiok with Ugin. Alright. But yeah, they didn't have too many cards left to try to kill me. So Legion's End, Angrass Rampage, Cry the Carnarium. Cry is the best of getting rid of the Cauldron Familiar for good. But again, it costs three just like everything else. So I don't really want to play another Cry the Carnarium. Hey, thanks Bias Green. Thanks for the tier one sub. I could just, I guess I could put another Legion's End in instead of like the Elder Spell or Rampage, but I probably need to keep those. Yeah, that's really a two. That's really a one. All right, let's try this again. This is such a weird deck. Yeah. Yeah, I like Feeder Frenzy plus Theater. I don't think I played it. I don't think I played that game perfectly. Magic's tough. Yes, Cry of the Carnarium is better than Legion's End. However, as you can see by my hand, I have too much competition for the 3-mana slot for just 3-mana cards, and when I'm trying to cast multiple stuff, like I'm trying to cast multiple cards a turn with the help of Frenzy and Theater, and having everything cost 3-mana is it makes that plan difficult. Don't have Golos. Got punished for not playing this. I kind of thought like if they're not just playing anything, like maybe it's a counterspell. And so I didn't play the Ashiok there, but that was the exact play that punished me for not playing Ashiok. But of course this could have just been countered. You know, I don't know. I can't say that wouldn't have been countered. I don't know. All right, well, they didn't have very many cards in hand, so I wanted to just to attack their hand while we could there.
I know more than you could learn in 1,000 lifetimes.
That's a lot of lifetimes. Draw land. Yay. Let's get to double spell.
I will seek other allies.
All right, Ashiok or Rider or Giant? It's not Rider, Ashiok or Giant. Do I just keep attacking here? Yeah. Awesome, good job, Soka. You went 4-2 with the troll deck from yesterday. Cool. Good job.
I battle for the forces of good.
The forces of good. So I guess we're battling corruption. Without the forces of good. It's kind of pretentious. Just to assume that your side is the forces of good. So, of course, I could attack them and then Rampage Karn. We're going to save the Rampage, though, to be able to take out something else.
And thank you for the lesson.
There's one Cauldron Familiar that's exiled. Oh, that's real aggressive there, Jund guy. Just while they're tapped out here, bedevil the egg so they can't gain three life and rampage the Karn and then attack for four. They can stay at eight and they can keep their egg, but I'm just going to get more stuff on the battlefield and I still have these removal spells in the chamber. So they didn't play anything. The option to play stuff, notably Meteor Giant, and said, no, I'm good.
I leave you with... This has been a nightmare.
Oh, that makes sense. All right, that makes sense.
My victory was but a dream.
All right, got Mystic Forge. And a Guild Globe out of there. And yeah, I could have rampaged the egg. I think it's kind of a waste of a rampage, though. Yeah, that was a very efficient use of Blast Zone. Yeah, I do, Lenziller. Yep. Ooh, got rid of Spyglass that was on top. All right, so that's two Mystic Forge gone. Fortunately, our Ashiok got rid of a lot of land. Not ideal. I can rampage that thing. I don't feel so bad rampaging that. Because they're at six lands now after getting rid of that other one.
Oh, it's you burning.
I don't think I just play a 2-3 whenever they could just draw land, Meteor Golem, Chandra.
I advise that you...
They'll be able to go get another...
I am not frightened by
another Spyglass. That hurts. That really hurts. That really hurts. And now I'm kind of like out of artifact removal.
I have let my friends down.
I bet they named Chandra. Good call. They named the correct Chandra also. Darn. I was really hoping that they didn't realize that I was going to have lethal. Like, if I played Bonecrusher Giant last turn, it's very obvious that I have lethal. I was hoping that they wouldn't realize that I would have lethal and not get a blocker. Alright, all we need to do... Our whole deck is removal. All we need to do is draw a removal spell and two draws. That's a lot of removal. Kill that thing.
This is just gonna be bad for you.
They said good game, so I'll say good game back. All right, we're 1-1 now. After an hour and 20 minutes, because we had the one game that we were in game two, and then my opponent just disconnected. I didn't count it as a win. All right, I'm going to reset arena. It's acting slow. No, destroying a Chandra doesn't count as removing the loyalty. Yeah, it just forces the Chandra to just leave the battlefield. So no, I couldn't just like play the other Chandra and then removes loyalty and does damage. Traditional, standard, ranked. Rakdos Control. Yeah, that's a very good match. The Omniscience draft is M20. And I've never drafted M20. Y'all will have to help me with the Omniscience draft there when we get there. Draft the highest CMC card? No, that's not what you do. You draft any card that says draw a card. That's all you do, is draft any card that says draw a card. Sorry for hitting the mic there. Proof. Just no attack there, huh? All right, let's get this theater working. Really?
Go ahead. Beg you. Back to the shadows for now.
You can go back to the shadows for now.
Anyway.
Well, good news is they don't have any black mana. Bad news, they have a 5/5. Which I guess I should kill. I really wanted to play Theater Fours, though. That's a whole lot of basic forests for this Murderous Rider deck over here. Edgewall Innkeeper. Edgewall Innkeeper. Go ahead and sacrifice that. Chompers. We'll see if we hit more land drops. Okay. Wasn't red mana, but good enough. I got more removal for Murderous Riders and stuff. I don't have to worry about... I don't think I have to really have to worry about keeping that Murderous Rider.
Yeah, we're good.
Alright, so all we have to do is have our opponent not be able to play like their whole deck. They draw 5 basic forests. Not a black land to be found. This is a perfect matchup for Legion's End. Cry the Carnarium. Gotta exile these Innkeepers. Golgari Queen's really annoying, though. Destroying Theater of Horrors. That's really annoying. I guess we just get rid of those. Making them sacrifice a Planeswalker with Rampage can be good, but like their creatures with them playing, you know, Lovestruck Beast, making little 1/1 tokens and the 1/1 Death Touchers and things like that. Like those aren't things that I, you know, the, so like the Rampage's value is down pretty low here. Yeah, well, we haven't played against Oko yet. Yeah, it is. The thing is, it's so good against the Yoko decks, but yeah, it is. It's been underwhelming against all the opponents that we've been playing against, for sure. All right, they got Veil of Summer over there. Rankle's going to be a problem. Wrinkle's definitely going to be a problem. I guess they're waiting a turn to play Wrinkle before Like, so they can have Veil of Summer available? Hmm. Rampage doesn't really stop. I guess maybe playing this Frenzy before Rankle was a mistake. Just draw a lot of cards. Alright, how am I dealing with these Veil of Summers? Guess I'm gonna have to like maybe play more Duress. Rankle and Midnight Reaper. Those have been two cards that have just been destroying me. Yeah, Veil of Summer is just kind of unbeatable. I'm gonna take out Carnage for Duress. I still don't understand how that whole cycle in M20, all of them cost two except for Veil of Summer only costs one, and then also Veil of Summer draws a card. I basically don't understand why that card draws a card. It would be a really good sideboard card even if it didn't draw a card. As is, it makes no sense. Even if it, like, if it was two mana, it would still be the best of the cycle if it was two mana. But they made it just one mana. The whole cycle is only two colors. Yeah, it's only blue and black, but that whole cycle. You know, like, Devout Decree is only red or black. You know, kind of thing. The whole cycle is like that. Aether Gust is just blue, is green and red. Green was a joke pre-M20. Green was a joke pre-M20? You know, right after pre-M20 was Ravnica Allegiance when Hydroid Crisis was there. The deck everybody was playing... Green was a joke? The deck everybody was playing was Wildgrowth Walker, Jade Light Ranger, Vivian, Crasis, Find Finality. Green was still the best color. I mean, green, I mean, I like green, so like I like, I'm not really complaining about it, but green's been the best color in standard since, I don't know, like Den Protector Deathmiss Raptor like 5 years ago. It's just always had the most card advantage since then. Whether it's Tireless Tracker or Rogue Refiner or Nissa Vastwood Seer. Basically saying, I guess what I'm trying to say is saying that green was a joke in standard at any point in the last 5 years is an incorrect statement. Just very incorrect. Stupid hexproof.
Close your eyes and listen to the sounds of the wild.
So I could activate castle upkeep.
Stomping time.
And then, you know, I would have only lost one life instead of two, but then I would have just had two mana. I lose three life. I wish that was another swamp. I could still activate castle. That's a good draw for them. Yay, it hits. Okay. Battle of the Castle Lock Twains here. Down to seven. Down to five. Alright, looks like they have Veil of Summer. That's my guess, or how it asking them to. To do stuff. So we're gonna do this. They Veil of Summer, I respond, and GG. All right, we beat the Golgari deck. 2-1. A lot of good early removal there. Hey, and we rank up. Where are we at? 1:38 in the league? Okay. All right, we'll play one more. I got, what, yeah, we have time for one more. And then we'll do these. Jared make a deck featuring Agent of Treachery and Yurok. I have. Last format, though I played them a lot more. This format, I only really put together one deck with those, and the deck didn't do very well at all, and so I wouldn't really recommend. I wouldn't recommend it. It was a Cauldron of Eternity list. I think that's all I've done there. I think I might have it like the beginning of the format, but does the? Yeah. So I guess so. Basically, what I'm saying is, you know, I've played those two decks a lot together. I don't really have a specific list that I'd recommend with those two cards right now. Yeah, Sultai Treachery was awesome. And then that's the thing. Oko made Yurok so much worse. But we're going to be trying to play Yurok next with four color elementals. Golgari is really good. Golgari is, it's really good against control decks. Yeah, we had a lot of really bad luck with Grixis Amass. The deck seemed okay, we just had a lot of really bad luck. Dang, Rake, That's really bad. So you're at 250 games played and you're on the play 67 times. So you've been on the draw 183. That's rough. What's a better chance that they have in their deck? Probably Veteran, but yeah, it was Veteran. I'm gonna say probably Veteran, but the Ebon Legion's a lot scarier. Perfectly good 2-mana removal here with Rampage. That hurts. That really hurts. Those two draws in a row. Worthy Knight, Midnight Reaper. think I just have to kill Veteran because it's just so much damage. Of course, if I would have just Legion's End the Veteran, you know, it's obviously it's all hindsight. You know, we don't know what's gonna happen. But if I would have Legion's End the Veteran instead. That game would have been pretty easily won, but instead we got destroyed. Not pretty easily won. That's not correct, but would have been a lot better for us. I don't understand. House B-Golem, what's the question? You're asking how statistically unlikely is what? I didn't see the rest of it. This is the kind of matchup we want to be playing against, though. That hurts losing game one. Our main deck is... And by is, I mean should be very good in the matchup in general. We have a lot of cheap removal. Like this is the kind of matchup that we want to be playing against, for sure. But as you saw there at the end of the game, you know, like my hand was the carnival that didn't kill something, a frenzy, and three lands. Oh, how unlikely is it to start 26% of times out of 250 games? Yeah, I mean, it's just, isn't that just it? It's just, I don't know if there's anything more than it's just 26% likely in a 250 game sample size. That seems like, I think that's just the number. Yeah, we got some sweepers. These ritual sets are main deck. I have a lot of good 2-mana removal. These things are like 2-mana removal. So a lot of good. I guess not very much one. A lot of two. And then we got a couple cries, a couple soots. Oh, I don't really pay attention to have lands on the right or lands on the left. I guess I've liked lands on the right more. And this hand would be perfect if I had double red, or double black, sorry. I have more black sources than red sources in here. I have 7 mountains and swamps, so that's the same, but I have 2 black castles, so that gives me an extra 2 black mana sources. So like 4 Blood Crypt, 4 Fable Passage, 7 swamps. And 2 castles. I should probably just wait on that shock. That's a bad play by me there. So I should see. I mean, it ended up being the right play because I would have shocked that still, but I wanted to see if maybe they had more Knight of the Ebon Legion or not. Alright, so black mana source. I have 4, 8, 10, 16. 16 more black mana sources. Cool. All I had to do was draw one with keeping this hand. All I had to do was draw one. Yay. We drew one. I'm honestly surprised they weren't attacking with the Midnight Reaper. Like, even just attacking with all. Yeah, honestly, they should have just been attacking out. Because they get to pump the 2-1 to be a 3-1 because of the... This thing pumps the Swordmaster to be a 3-1. So Ember Cleave would only do 6 damage to me. Even if they have, like, land Ember Cleave. Land Circle of Loyalty? Against a deck with a ton of removal, you do not want to be playing Circle of Loyalty. But yeah, as you saw there, you know, games 2 and 3. That, like I said, like that's a matchup that we really like facing. That's a really favorable matchup for the Rakdos Control deck. So, we didn't get to play against Oko, and you know what? We haven't played against Oko at all yet today. We've played 9 matches. This one, you know, we were 3-1, but we were in game 2 in another match where our opponent got disconnected. And, you know, I didn't count that towards the record. So, we've played 9 matches today, and we actually played against Oko 0 times. Tons and tons of Midnight Reaper. We faced... Lots and lots of Midnight Reaper. So that's kind of weird, but... Yeah, this deck played okay. I think it's going to be really good against the small creature decks, like we saw those last couple. I think that's really, like... You know, we have a lot of good removal for small creatures. The Kryla Carnarium... Because of our matchups, the Kryla Carnariums were amazing, and I wish I had more of them. I don't know if it's necessary to have more of them overall in the format. Basically that there. It would be, like, one thing is, it really would be nice to have an easier way to trigger Theater of Horrors consistently, to be able to play the cards underneath it. But that's kind of a luxury. Like, I don't think that I want to be playing Spawn of Mayhem or the Stormfist Crusader or cards like that that do 1 damage to each player during our turn, because we are a control deck. I really don't want that damage to pile up on my side. I think that's more of a luxury. But we just don't have a great... That's a main reason why I'm playing Carnival. Like, I think it's just a pretty solid card, but it's not, like, the absolute best. But it's a really good way to trigger Theater of Horrors. Whether it's, you know, Carnival or Carnage. The Carnage looked pretty good for us, though. Like, I cast Carnage a lot more than I cast Carnival, and Carnage was a lot better than Carnival was. But yeah, lots of Planeswalker removal. That's definitely a strength of the deck, you know, between the Rampages, Bedevils, Riders, and the Noxious Grasp against, if we play against the green ones, and then Elder Spells on the board. I do think, like, the second Elder Spell could come out for a third Cry of the Carnarium for, like, if we're going to be playing against those kind of same matchups again. But the Krylar Carnera matchups are a little favorable for us anyway. I think you can probably get away with just the two. So, you know, that could be another spell for other type of matchups. I'm not sold at all on, so like basically this second Elder spell is a luxury. So, you know, you have an open sideboard slot there. And I'm not super sold on Davriel. We didn't really play against like the blue control decks, which is what Davriel's in there for. But this could also be something else if you want extra sideboard slots. I did like the Ashiok. I do like the Ashiok plan. I wouldn't mind just playing four Ashioks and not playing Davriel's. I don't know. That's maybe not the way to go about it, though. Yeah, I think three Theater, three Frenzy were good. I'm glad we weren't just playing like four Theater, four Frenzy, because you know you do need like a lot of removal. Like you just kind of need like one of those in the late game to get that card advantage to take over. Noxious Grasp looked really bad for most of the time because we weren't really playing against any Oko decks. I would rather have like Lava Coil there. Lava Coil, that's another card that exiles. That's another good removal spell. If you're not playing against very much Oko, Lava Coil is a really good card to put in there, and maybe it's better than Carnival to have. It can kill bigger things like Rankle. Like Rankle is a problem, and it also gets around Veil of Summer too. So yeah, Lava Coil is a good one. Because with this deck, you want to keep your 1 and 2 mana count high. You know, like you can count these Bone Crushers as like twos basically. You need to keep that 1 and 2 mana count high because you need to be able to cast a lot of spells each turn. Because with like Frenzy, you want to play a lot of spells every turn. Kind of same thing with getting extra cards with Theater. You really want to keep your 1 and 2 mana count high and try to stay away from threes and fours with other cards. So yeah, like Omnix's Cruelty costs 3. Like I'm not interested. And it also gets Veil of Summer, everything like that. Like Lava Coil is something I'm a lot more interested in. Epic Downfall, another good option. Because, yeah, I guess, yeah, Wicked Wolf can be problematic. I have the Rampages for it, though. But I would rather have Epic Downfall than Omnixilis's Cruelty. Because, again, it costs 2, not 3. And it can just get a whole lot of creatures. You know, any creature that costs 3 or more. There. Okay. That's all I got there for Rakdos Control, though. Hopefully that helps you out if you're playing it later on YouTube. Of course, leave those comments. Let me know how it's going for you, how you like the deck, and everything like that. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.